Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, Venerable Master, Dharma Master, all wholesome advisors, good afternoon and Amitabha. Today is the July of 2nd, 2023. So we talk about many Dharma doors which I didn't pay attention to translate. The Flower Adornment Sutra, the Flower Adornment is the base of the sutra. It's the is a Mahayana teachings.
那么它这个大的动起来，小的动，那么就会推动翻译、出版、宣传、交流和教育。So
when the large view, the Mahayana view will turn the Theravada view. The smaller view, as the big view is turning, the small view will also turn along its way. So this will push with the publishing the books and many other teachings.
所以我们看看参加法会的大部分的信众都是大人哈，然后我们就会好奇说，如果有小孩子参加这个法会的话，他一定很有善根。 那我们就很想听听他的心得感受等等的，在万佛圣城每次法会完之后，都会有一个给大家分享心得的机会。那我们这边可能没有这个安排，那我就想说，借着这个机会，刚好陈志喜、陈国平的儿子他过来看我们，那我想说，不如安排他们两个同时上来，给大家介绍一下我们这边。 佛教社团办了哪一些活动？如何跟我们这个法会能够，能够衔接起来？然后通过我们这个法会推动本地的这些佛教社团的一些活动等等，就是把这个法缘这个法推广开来。所以我们的一个初衷是这样子想的。So
there are a lot of kids who get in touch, get connected to the Dharma, So we are luckily to have this chance to have two of the students from City of 10,000 Buddhas to participate and share some of their experiences and reflections, which is connected to the Avatamsaka Sutras. And this is going to be universally, wisely connect to many other worlds.
所以说到这个教育呢，那我们。 马来西亚这边的孩子到万佛圣城去念书，培德中学啊，培德兰校里校去念书，他们考的学校都很不错，像那个 Tech Law 的儿子考到普林斯顿大学，王慧茹那个金平子的儿子考到那个哥伦比亚，然后Melvin考到加州理工大学。 他妹妹呢，考到浙江大学，然后我右边右手这边这个陈志喜，他考到他们一家四个孩子都考到我们马来西亚这边的一个厦门大学，所以很殊这个因缘很殊胜。那么 Elvin 是2016年从我们南校毕业的，那陈志喜其实是2019年从我们南校毕业的，就他们两个。
So we have many Malaysians who has the chance to go and study in the United States in City of 10,000 Buddhas, and some of us came back, and for example, one of the students went to Columbia, graduated from City of 10,000 Buddhas and went to Columbia University. And one of them went to California Polytechnic San Luis Obispo, and another went to one of the famous school in Malaysia to study the medical, being doctors. So the students on the left graduated from Cal Poly San Luis, graduated from City of 10,000 Buddhas in 2016, and the students from the right graduated in 2019.
好，那我们这段今天的时间就分成两段，前面的20分钟交给Elvin，然后后面的20分钟就交给Chihi。那 如果你们准备好，可以开始讲。
Okay, so, we will separate the time or divide the times into two. So, the first half will be spoken by the student on the left, and the second half will be spoken by the student on the right. Okay, so I'm a graduate student from the City of 10,000 Buddhas, and who has taken the five precepts, and I may appear calm and composed on the table, but I have an unusually strong attachment as well as many delusion thoughts. So particularly when it comes to my ego, so I have caused quite a bit of trouble for the school, so to speak. How should I put it? It has left a very good impression in many people's heart. I should speak in Chinese too, okay. So, 别看我在桌上一脸平静的模样，是一个受了五戒，而且是万佛圣城的毕业生。其实我妄想执着特别的重，尤其是我执方面的问题，给学校带来了挺多的麻烦。怎么说呢，就比较深入人心，对。所以啊，如果你要找圣城的毕业生，应该找我右边的那一位。他虽然也是，我虽然也算是一个，但是属于比较那种可恶的那一种类型。So if you are looking for a graduate student from City of 10,000 Buddhas, you should approach to the person next to me. So while I'm considered as one as well, but I'm more despicable. So, 就是这样，定力得恒修行，不足的我其实想就这样放下麦克风，然后跟大家说一句谢谢。但是在座的各位用心参与华严法会的老师，默默付出的菩萨法师，以及医生愿意给学生坐在这里学习的机会，我只好多加努力。That's why as someone who lacks moral cultivation and inner stability in patience, in practices, I actually want to put down my microphone and say thank you everyone. However, to all esteemed individuals presented here, the dedicated teachers who wholeheartedly participate in the Avatamsaka Sutras, and the Bodhisattvas who silently contribute, and the doctor, those who have generously provided this opportunity for students to sit here and learn, so I can strive harder in response. So, 华严经以及我个人的经历和感想吗？ So what are the experience and reflections on Avatamsaka Sutra in relation to my time in City of 10,000 Buddhas? So 从圣城毕业已经有超过六七年的时间了，所以我能分享的其实也不多，除了看圣城里的菩萨默默的付出之外，就是在看菩萨准备付出的路上。Honestly, there isn't much. It has been more than 6 years since I graduated from City of 10,000 Buddhas. Apart from observing the many Bodhisattvas who contribute silently, I'm also on my way to witness their preparations for selfless activities. 至于我在圣城做了什么，除了学习以外，我们也有参与一些日常做的义工，比如说 community service, 时不时会到外面的世界去结善缘，比如说舞狮舞龙和其他的 去其他国家之类的。然后还有就是就给菩萨们添加更多的工作。What else did I do? Aside from studying, I would engage in daily activities or daily volunteer works. Occasionally, we would venture out into the external world to create positive connections with other people. Oh, also, one of the good contributions I have is adding more responsibilities to the Buddha's workload. So, 从零散的记忆中我能分享的我所整理出来也能分享的就是一份对于圣诚菩萨的研究报告。From my scattered memory, all I can share is a research report on the Bodhisattvas living in City of 10,000 Buddhas. So, 华严经呢是大圣佛法的一本教学书，里面说了很多和菩萨息息相关的内容，比如说华严世界的详细背景，从凡夫到52个菩萨境界，其中的五个十就是十性、十住、十恒、十回向、十地，再加上等觉、妙觉，一共52个菩萨境界。The Avatamsaka Sutra is like a textbook of Mahayana Buddhism, which contains many chapters of teachings closely related to cultivations, the Bodhisattva's path. It describes in details of the background of Avatamsaka world and the progression from ordinary beings to the 52 stages of Bodhisattva's realizations. These stages are known as the 52 gates, including 10 faiths, 10 abodes, 10 practices, 10 dedications, 10 grounds, along with the realization of awaiting enlightenment and perfectly enlightenment. 因此本研究报告将介绍且展示一些人们在万佛圣城如何修行菩萨道的一些例子。Therefore, the research report will introduce and demonstrate some examples of how people practice the Bodhisattva's path in the city of 10,000 Buddhas. 最开始呢，踏入菩萨道的道路上有个十性位 ,10 faith, 十性位。这十性位呢主要收集资粮，为我们的粮仓里添加更多的食物，为修行做好更充足的准备。At the very beginning of the path to the practice of Bodhisattvas, there are 10 stages of faith. These 10 faiths are mainly for cultivating or collectingsustenance, filling out our storage with more food and preparing us for further future cultivation. 简单来说，就好比如圣城那些四处爱挖洞的松鼠啊，在洞里储存大量的食物，为寒冬做好准备。In other words, like squirrels in the city of 10,000 Buddhas, they will search for food days and nights.Storing their foods and nuts in their nests so they can sustain longer and live through the winter. 储存了足够多的食物，有了足够多的资粮之后，十性位的菩萨可以前进一步步入十住位。Once one prepares enough food, enough sustenance, the 10th phase Bodhisattva may take a step forward, entering the stage of 10 abodes. 除此之外，就以恒顺师作为研究身为学生的我们，就怎么说，从来没见过恒顺师生气的模样。 Other than this, let's put Dharma Master 恒顺 as an example. As students, we never seen him getting angry. 有几次在上课的时候，我们这些学生呢真的刺激到他了，然后他就对我们笑了笑，然后默默地走到一旁的角落，喃喃自语道， 他们是来帮助我修行的，他们是来帮助我修行的。嗯，这很重要，所以他重复了两次。The few times that we have actually irritated him, the few times that we have actually irritated him, he responded with a smile, mumbling, saying, "You are here to help me cultivate. You are here to help me cultivate." It was important, so he repeated it twice. 这也许是菩萨道的一种修行。This perhaps is a practice of the Bodhisattva path, which is too profound for me to understand. 说到恒顺师高中时期最后一年，我们都会有一个佛学课，其中大部分的内容呢，现在想起来都跟华严经息息相关。而恒顺师就是我们最后一年佛学课的老师，其中他的佛学课描述了天人、宇宙、时间以及各大菩萨的境界与修行。Speaking of Dharma Master Heng Shun, we have something called the Buddhism class during our senior year in high school. Now I recall most of the contents and teachings from the Buddhism class are related to Avatamsaka Sutra. And of course, Dharma Master Heng Shun is our teacher. It includes the teachings of the heavens, the Buddhist cosmology, and the measurement of time, and many different stages or practices of the Bodhisattvas. 但是呢，非常抱歉，大部分的内容呢，我都交还给恒顺师了。But unfortunately, I have returned most of my studies back to Dharma Master 恒顺。So, 佛学课呢，我记得佛学课呢，恒顺师曾说过，末法时代也是斗争最特别激烈的时代，就好像六界中的阿修罗一样好斗。During Buddhism class, Dharma Master Heng Shun once said, "The Dharma ending age is also known as the age of the age strong in fighting. Is as strong as fighting, like Asuras." So, 国家的战争，工作的竞争。随着天灾的到来，未来可怕的大地震啊，伴随着海啸，可能会让资源进入缺乏的情况。因此，因为资源不足，可能会带来更多的争斗。The wars between countries, the competitions for jobs, the current and upcoming disaster like earthquakes, followed by tsunami, available resources,will become insufficient for us, resulting in more fightings. So, 这样的未来呢，该怎么做？面对什么样的选择？ How should we cultivate in the future, and what is our path of cultivation? Honestly, I don't really know the answer about it. So, I believe the cultivation should be.The answer can be found in the Avatamsaka Sutra. That's why we should study and research Avatamsaka Sutra. 其实呢，对于这样的问题，我个人是没有答案的。但是，这就是我们应该研究去学习《华严经》的原因。从《华严经》里面，随因缘里面找到自己的修行法门，找到自己的答案。就从华严经可以摸索到末法时代修行的道路以及方法。Study the Avatamsaka Sutra, there's an answer in Avatamsaka Sutras. So, 我就说一些我自己的例子吧。我呢，个人是，我是毕业了过后，就最后一年的时候才受五戒的。我毕业于圣城之前就觉得我去了大学可能就没有机会接触佛法了，所以我就受了五戒来时时刻刻可能就想着，这五戒可能就是我的佛法，我的修行。After graduating from City of 10,000 Buddhas, I chose to take the five precepts because I feel like once I enter college, I won't have the chance to stay connected to Buddhism, to study Buddhism. That's why I took the five precepts. And, 然后我拿了，我受了五戒之后呢，就如我想所想的一样，也就真的没有什么机会接触佛法。但我对我个人对十二因缘是比较有缘的，就我第一次听到十二因缘是从我不太记得了，我第一次听到十二因缘的时候，我就特别的欢喜，就特别想找时间去学习，去愿意花时间去了解，去背这十二因缘的东西。然后as I graduated from City of 10,000 Buddhas, and when I first heard of the 12 courses and conditions, the courses and conditions, yeah, I feel really joyful, and I really put my time and memorize and study the teachings. So, 其实我有很多关于佛法的东西我还不了解，我只知道那种皮毛的东西就也无明啊，就in ignorance. So, 所以就我们呢在末法时代可能就会遇到很多那些骗子啊，可能会利用你的善心、你的修行或者是道恨。但因为他们其实也无可奈何，因为末法时代，而且如果有战争之类、天灾之类的问题，他们自己生存也可能是一个问题，所以他们可能就会利用这一部分的方面。所以我觉得行菩萨道真的是很难很难，就如果你就算被利用了，被他们这样子比如说得难听点，就比较恩将仇报的感觉，那你还可以一个平静的心去接受，去面对这样的问题。So as I in the Dharma ending age, there will be people who may lie to you, who may take advantage of your kindness so that they can survive in this poverty or in this all this disaster. So it makes me feel like the Bodhisattva's path is really difficult to walk to. That's why I feel really respect. I really respect and really want to learn and study more about the Bodhisattva path. But 这呢也跟其实也跟无明也有关系。如果你无明没有这么重的话，你可能就不会这么容易被骗了，可能就会就算被骗也是有心理准备的被骗。So if your ignorance is not that heavy, you won't be able to get tricked by this karma or tricked by these people who needs to survive. Even if you are tricked by these people, you are mentally prepared. 所以呢，我这就是我所能想到的有关于跟圣城的一些关系跟华严经。阿弥陀佛。